Hi, my name is Mike Mancini. I'm founder of PPCvideotraining.com. This quick video is a tutorial on how we keep track of our statistics when we are going through our Google Ads accounts. A lot of people will say, well, how do you know what's working, what's not, how to keep track of what, just an overall overview of what's working for you and what's working for this campaign. It's very hard because you're always in those campaigns changing a ton of things, whether it's keywords, ads, landing pages, whatever it might be. But this will give you a quick overall overview. So what you can do is you can go in, enter the statistics, and then the next time you go in, enter your statistics again, and you can compare to the previous time frame. That will let you know what? We're not liking what these numbers are doing overall. So maybe we should go back and undo those changes. Or you start seeing, all right, we're on the right track. We see an increase in clicks. We see an increase in click-through rates, in conversions, whatever it might be. All right, so here is a quick tutorial on how to use our stats spreadsheet. You can go down below this video and there's a download link where you can download the spreadsheet for free. All right, let's get started. All right, so here we are on our PPC stats spreadsheet. Now, there are some numbers that are already going to be filled in. This is just because this actually gives you an idea kind of how it works. But before we go too far, let me show you exactly where you are going to get your statistics from. All right, here we are inside an actual Google Ads account. And I want to show you where we get our statistics from in this account and how we have it set up. So in this particular instance, we are looking at impressions, clicks, click-through rate, average cost per click, total cost, all conversions, cost per all conversion rate, average position, search impression share, and all changes. Now, if you don't see these column headings up here, all you have to do is go up to columns, modify columns. Under performance, we want impressions, clicks, click-through rate, average cost per click, cost, and average position. Under conversions, we'd like to see all conversion, all cost per all conversion rate. Go down to competitive metrics, search impression share, and then down at the bottom, change history, all changes. And we will put these in this particular order so it matches up with our spreadsheet. Impressions, clicks, click-through rate, average cost per click, then cost, all conversions, cost, all conversion rate, average position, search impression share, and then all changes. And what you do is you just move these around, drag them around into whatever order you want. Then we usually will save this column set, call them whatever you want. We call ours custom, and then click save and apply. Back on our spreadsheet, what I want you to do is I want you to enter a start date. So for instance, if today's the first day of the year, I want you to enter that. You can put your campaign name in here if you'd like. Then what I want you to do is I want you to take all the statistics for a particular period of time. Now that might mean a year, it might mean 6 months. I want it to be a pretty significant amount of time because if you haven't really kept up with and monitored your changes, it's great to see where your campaign was overall. So if you, let's just say it's the previous 6 months, I want you to enter those stats in. You would go back to your campaign, click on the custom date, and enter in whatever date it would be. Whether it's the previous 6 months or whatever it might be, and then enter those statistics in here. Now these are actual numbers in here from a campaign, and you can see that this campaign had a click-through rate of 2.29%, 85 conversions, and I believe this was a 1 year period for this campaign. They weren't spending a whole lot of money, around $500 to $600 a month, and we just entered in all that information here. Looks like we forgot the search impression share, but we'll just skip over that for right now. Now down here, I want you to say, let's just say that you are starting in January and you've taken all the statistics for January, just the 1 month of January, and you've put them in here. And you go down here and we Always write the number of changes in, because we want to see if where we made the ton of changes or whether they were just one big change, whatever it might be. And you might be looking at this going, how was there 124 changes to this account? Well, when we were going through this account, we saw these numbers and they just, we really weren't liking, especially this average position. So we went through and we bid up on a lot of keywords. And then on a lot of other keywords that we're not converting, we paused those keywords. So if you're bidding up on all your keywords by 5%, of course, it's very easy to make 124 changes in a matter of seconds if you're using Google Ads Editor. As I said, this is an actual campaign, and we went through and we recorded our stats for all of January and made 124 changes in January. So let's go back and look at the end of February and see what happened. Now at the end of February, here are our statistics. And we go through and we got a few more clicks. Our click-through rate jumped by almost a full percentage point. Our average cost per click went up a little bit, about 20 cents. And so did our total cost, about $63. However, we did get three more website conversions. Our cost per conversion dropped. Now these were only website conversions, but that dropped by about 10 bucks a conversion. Our conversion rate went up. Look at this, our average position jumped from 2.6 to 2.4. Here's where it gets amazing. Our calls jumped almost 60% from 35 to 51. Now our search impression share dropped. So that's something that we can change later, but our leads went from 44 to 63 and went from $12 a lead to 9.5. Literally all from these 124 changes that we made. Now, if we're not keeping a close eye on this, what ends up happening is we just see, okay, well, we got 63 conversions, but we might not know why. And we might not know when exactly those changes were. Now this is on a monthly scale. So this is January, February, March. This is if you're only doing changes every month. If you have a small campaign that's not spending a ton of money, you are probably going to need to let a campaign run longer to get the statistics that you need. You know, you can't make a change and let it run for five clicks, and if it doesn't get a conversion, you need to stop it. You need to let Google make its changes in its algorithm based on the changes that you've made to your account, and you need to let it run for a period of time. How long is that time? It varies widely depending on how much you're spending, really, and are you getting enough statistics? But typically, I would let a campaign spend $200 to $300 before I really knew if a campaign was working well, or if the changes that I made were working well. But as you can see in this instance, we spent only $70 more, but we increased our leads by over 20. Now I just happen to know that this campaign, this client, he gets an average of $200 for every new customer. So an extra 70 bucks in ad spend, an extra 20 leads, he closes it at easily 60% of the leads that he gets in. It's a small service business. So by all means, he's extremely happy with these changes that we made already in month one. Now, because of what happened here, we only made a few small changes to the account because we want to see if it's going to continue to run that way. And some of those changes were based on what we see here, our search impression share dropped quite a bit, so we went and increased some bids on some keywords that are getting clicked quite a bit, but maybe aren't showing as often as they should. So we made a few small changes. Now, in a week, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in and we're gonna record our statistics again. Now, I know you see this right here where it says, wait a minute, January, February, March, this is just a guideline. We ran it for January, we made a bunch of changes, we let it run because, and we were keeping an eye on it. We're not just looking at this once a month. We were in there looking at it rather regularly, but we're just using these 2 months here as an example. So what you may end up doing is be like, all right, week January, week one, January, week two, and so on. Or you may just be like, all right, 1/1/18, 1/7/18, 1/14/18, and recording the stats every single week. But once again, I would not go in and make a ton of changes until you actually realize that those changes need to be made. You need to let these run for a bit. But this is a guideline. And if you go down here, it shows you your leads going, our leads went from 44 to 63, and our cost per lead went from 1222 down to 953. And then they dropped to zero because we don't have any information in these columns right here. But as you add them, this graph will update automatically. Now, this is just a guideline. This is something that we use on certain campaigns. We will change these headers based on the information that we want are looking at. So feel free to mess around with this worksheet all you want. Just a guideline once again, but it's something that we use on a very regular basis. And if you like it, please let us know in the comments below. Or if you have any comments or ideas about changes that we could make to make it better, let us know by all means. Thanks so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please like it and subscribe to our channel, or share it with someone who might find it interesting. Or if you know of someone who's in need of PPC or Google Ads services, please forward our information to them. We'd love to help. Thanks so much for watching.